need you to hit the subscribe button below.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart. The Bible said we should not hate our brother in our heart. Read. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor. But we're supposed to correct thy neighbor. When you see a brother or a young man in your neighborhood going off, you're supposed to put him to the side. Hey, young brother, don't be doing that. Don't be robbing your community. Right. Don't be tearing up your neighborhood. Don't be disrespecting your moms. Read. And not suffer sin upon him. And we're not supposed to be okay with seeing our people breaking God's commandments. Like today, we're not okay with seeing our people break the Sabbath day, because we understand it's punishable by death. Read. Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people.
The children of who?
The children of thy people.
The children of thy people. Thy people. Your neighbor is the children of your people.
That's right.
If they're not from your nation, according to the Bible, they're not your people. Let's go back to Matthew. This is what Christ was talking about, but the problem is the laws of God are not being taught in the church. They tell you, read the New Testament. Well, guess what? The New Testament, New Covenant, is for the children of Israel. Read.
The book of Matthew, chapter 19, verse 19. Honor thy father and thy mother, and thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
So now, I'm going to show you, I love you like I love myself. Give me 1 Corinthians 3:16. I'm going to show you, my brother, I love you just like I love myself. Meaning, I don't want to see nothing bad happen to you like I don't want to see nothing bad happen to me. I'm going to tell you straight, that's exactly how we care about our people. That's what Christ commanded us. And I'm going to give you a commandment to show you I care about you. Read what you got.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 3 and verse 16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
So God is telling us, my brother over there with the cigarette, you're the temple of God.
Right.
There's no more physical temple, it's your body. Right. Like my body, his body, his body. Right. We are the temple of God. Read.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
Read.
If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
So when I see my brother defiling his temple with a cigarette, because I used to smoke it too. Right. I used to smoke weed. I did all that garbage. God said, if you defile your temple, him shall God destroy. On that cigarette, it said, will cause cancer.
Right.
And we know that. But I understand why a lot of us smoke it. A lot of us be stressed out. But it's not a permanent solution. It's a temporary fix. That's all it is, because I get it. You're smoking for now, get a little calm and relaxed. A lot of us dealing with stresses in our life. Some of us probably going to look like, bro, you don't know what I'm going through right now. I'm going to tell you something. The 1 Corinthians 10:13. God knows exactly what you're going through. Because you're going through it, I'm going through it, he going through it, he going through it. We all going through it. Ain't none of us different, bro. That's why he said you got to love your neighbor as you love yourself. Meaning, you got to look at your neighbor and see Christ and see, you know what? That's me I'm looking at over there. And I used to do it, and I understand what it did to my body, and I know what it can do to your body. Too many of us as black men is being killed by police. Right. We got to stop actually killing ourselves.
Right.
Read what you got.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 10 and verse 13. There have no temptation taking you, but such as common to man.
God said all the things you're tempted by is common to man. It's common to me, it's common to him. A lot of us used to smoke, a lot of us used to get drunk. It's nothing uncommon, and we did it to escape a lot of stresses. Like, for example, a lot of us had a woman, and if the woman stepped out, we were stressed out if she left. We go chill out with the boys, we go get a drink, we go get a brew, get drunk at the bar, fire up a couple blunts, and then we chill for the night. But guess what? A lot of us has happened too. A lot of us has lost loved ones, and we turned to a cigarette or tobacco. A lot of us has lost people we care about. A lot of us has lost jobs. COVID-19 just happened. A lot of us is homeless right now. But what do we turn to? We turn to a cigarette. We turn to alcohol because we need comfort. Read it again.
There have no temptation taking you, but such as is common to man.
So right now, what you're dealing with, bro, anything you got, it ain't nothing uncommon. God already know about it.
Right.
Because there's somebody that can identify what you're going through. Read.
But God is faithful.
But now it says God is faithful. Read.
Who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able.
So when he said he's not going to allow you to basically be overwhelmed with it, meaning he's going to send somebody that's going to help you get through it. He sent us today to meet you. Get in Hebrews 3:13. I'm going to show you. God sent us right now today. And he made us go through the same thing he was going through. So he could be relatable to you. I ain't condemning you, brother. I'm being relatable to my brother because I understand. That thing don't feel good now. But you know, like I know, bro. That thing could cause lung cancer, emphysema. Bro, COVID-19 is going around right now. Where our lungs is being attacked by a plague. And we're putting smoke in our lungs. Think about that for a second. We're rocking a mask. Your brother in front of you, he got a mask on because he didn't want to catch COVID. Because COVID destroys your lungs. but then we're going to sit there and put smoke in our lungs that's destroying our lungs. You see what I'm saying there? Hebrews 3:13. The book of Hebrews, chapter 3, and verse 13. But exhort one another daily. God said exhort. That's why I'm exhorting you, my brother. You know what you could be right now? Toss that cigarette. Because guess what? You're stronger than that cigarette.
That's right.
All praise to the Most High God.
Right.
Now, was that hard to toss it? It wasn't. But you know what you needed? This is what you needed. Read it again. But exhort one another daily. We need to exhort each other daily. You got to be around brothers that's going to build you up.
Right.
Let's, like, for example, back in the day, we used to chill with our homeboys. Anytime we went through stuff, all we brought was the cigarette and weed and drugs. Well, now, these righteous men, we're going to give you the scriptures and help to exhort you to, so that you don't have to revert to those things. You understand? We're going to give you something to do so you're not occupied in that. Because I'm going to tell you something. When I started hanging around these brothers, I didn't think about smoking again. I didn't think about it again. Read it again.
But exhort one another daily while it is called today.
While you have the opportunity to talk to each other. God said exhort each other daily, meaning when I got an opportunity to talk to you, I should build you up and let you know, brother, you can toss it. That's the power you got. You know how powerful that is? I guarantee you, you'd be surprised. Somebody drove by and saw you do that and be like, you know what? I could quit too.
Right.
All praise to the Most High. And I understand it because, like, even myself, I smoke for over 16 years. It becomes addictive. It becomes a habit. This is Acts 17:24. And a lot of us, we do the same kind of thing. We try to gradually come up off it because we recognize now, I need to get this off me. So what you was doing so far is a good thing. You see how you tossed it right there?
Right.
Now, next time, instead of going buying it, don't even buy it all. Keep your money in your pocket. Read that real quick.
The book of Sirach, chapter 17, verse 24. But unto them that repent.
Unto them that what?
That repent.
What you just did was a sign of repentance. As small as it might look, that's powerful, read.
He granted them return.
God is going to grant you to return away from your sin, to come back to him because you showed actions, read.
And comforted those who failed in patience.
And he comforted those who failed in patience, meaning I couldn't do today without a cigarette. I had to get it. But look what he did, though. He didn't let you smoke the whole thing. He let you fire it up. We started teaching what happened. He allowed you to escape it by plucking it away, by bringing his word. Read.
Return unto the Lord and forsake thy sins.
So now God said, you know what? Come back to him. Find out about your nationality. Find out that you're not an African-American. You're an Israelite. Right? And start to keep his commandments. Come back to serving him and not the cigarette. Read.
Make thy prayer before his face.
Do what?
Make thy prayer before his face.
Because it's the thing. You can go home right now and pray to God, God, forgive me for my sins. And he'll forgive you if you're serious about it. If your actions back it up. Read.
And offend less.
That's exactly what you said you was doing. You was offending less. You was gradually come up off of it. You understand? Then Hebrews 10:25. You can come up here, yo. Hebrews 10:25. So now that you're offending less, right? What you doing today, brother? Say it again. Okay, so you go out home to chill, basically, right? I'm going to show you something. If you want to truly overcome that cigarette, now you got to remain around God-fearing people. Because remember, the Bible said, exhort you, right? I can only exhort you if you're right by me, just like you are right there, right? You said you're going home to cook. Today's a Sabbath day. We're going to go over that with you. But I want to show you, there's something you can do right now rather than going home and come to a better place to return to God. Hebrews 10:25.
The book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 25.
Come on.
Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together.
God said, don't take for granted being around righteous individuals. Read.
As the manner of some is.
These people that know this stuff and stay away from each other because they like to play with their sin. But those of us that don't want to do sin no more, he said, don't take for granted being around each other. Read.
But exhorting one another.
See, there we go again. You got to be around us to exhort. You got to convocate. We have a school right down the road, bro. 10 to 15 minutes away from here. Read.
And so much the more. As you see the day approach,
you realize this world is being destroyed, little by little. You got people over here grinding on Satan, making music videos talking about they worshiping the devil.
Right.
You got kids over here shooting at their pops.
Right.
You got sisters walking around half naked. You got World War III right around the corner.
Right.
God said, so much the more as you see destruction is coming. Read.
For if we sin willfully,
because if we take for granted coming together and we willfully sin, if you go home and willfully go cook on the Sabbath and fire up that cigarette, read.
After that, we have received the knowledge of the truth. And there remained no more sacrifices for sin.
So God said, if you reject him, There's no more ways he's going to forgive you. So I'm going to exhort my brother. Brother, come to the school. Call the number on that flyer and come to the school. I'm telling you. You want food? We got food at the school. We can feed you. That's the least. But we want to make sure that you're not in sin. Because if you cook today, that's sin. You smoke today, that's sin. As long as you're around us, you're going to be sin free. That's loving your neighbor as you love yourself. You understand that? And I want to see that for you. Because I want to see that for myself too as well.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.